Treatment of pelvic fracture posed a serious challenge in front of a treating orthopedic surgeon since years, and Malgagni and Tile has made quite a lot of research and work to make the fractures easy, to classify it and to give us management guidelines. Just before going to the fractured pelvis, we just know that pelvis is with a lot of important structures around and in it. It has a 7 nerves, 3 big vessels, 1 muscles attached to the greater, which comes out of the greater sciatic notch, lesser sciatic notch, which is separated from greater sciatic notch by a ischial spine, and obturator internus comes out of it. And also the pelvis has a true pelvis and false pelvis. True pelvis consists of all bladder or rectum or a uterus, and false pelvis consists of all your abdominal viscera. So any injuries to this part can give rise to damage to either these nerves, vessels or important abdominal structures. So what can go wrong with the bone? So for that we should know the joints of the pelvis. They are pubic symphysis and sacroiliac joints. They are more strong sacroiliac joints and slightly expandable pubic symphysis joint. These are the important slide which says you about the ligaments of pelvis, because when there is an injury, either bone will break or ligament will damage. So there are certain ligaments which connects to various parts of the pelvis. These are, first is you have to identify the pubic symphysis, symphysial ligament, anterior, inferior, superior, inferior. Then there are sacrotuberous ligaments, sacrum and ischial tuberosity. Then consist of a sacrospinous ligament, sacrum and the spinous process, ischial spine. And then comes the anterior sacroiliac ligament. These are the very important in the posterior structures, because all depends on whether they are ruptured or not ruptured, and in the end posterior sacroiliac ligaments. So these ligaments will give us important guidelines in management. So we'll come to know the how it happens. It happens because of very high energy injury, less commonly low energy injury. It's a fall from height or a high motor vehicle accident can cause this injury. Sudden deceleration, vertical shear, direct impact, lateral side impact, front impact can cause this injuries. So coming to the classification, we have anatomic classification as per the bone or joint involved. Then it comes as stable or unstable, whether that fracture is stable or unstable. Then Tiles, Young's and AO. Even AO has described this classification, but most important used is Young's, then Tiles and then AO. So once you get the fracture pelvis, if the patient is stable, then you can go ahead with the AP view, inlet view, outlet view and a CT scan. If the patient is unfit to shift to the X-ray department, you do it on casualty table only. That is must. On AP view, what you see is the pubic symphysis, the rami, then you see a sacral foramina and the sacral fractures. The inlet view is a good indicator of sacroiliac joint. Obturator view will give you a good indicator of pubic body, pubic symphysis and the level of the ischial tuberosities. It can tell you whether it is vertical shear or no. So these three views you should do. Then comes the Tiles classification. After X-ray you find out which class, type is it is. Either it is type A, which is stable, doesn't require any management, conservative management is needed, just a binder, it will, the patient will heal. Type B is most common, rotationally unstable and vertically stable. So it excludes vertical shear but consists of open book and lateral compression. That is type B. And type C is rotationally and vertically unstable, which is usually vertical shear injuries. So these are the workhorse of the fracture pelvis classification, that is Young's classification, lateral compression or open book or vertical shear or combine. So it is when you get an impact from the side, then you get a lateral compression. Either it is sacral compression on the side of the impact, usually stable. LC2 is iliac wing fracture, relative stable. LC3 is LC1 or LC2 with opposite side pelvis injury. So we'll just see, click, what happens when there is an injury from this side. This side is a direct impact, then this is gone in. So pubic rami is broken and it's gone in. And if you see the X-ray, you see this pelvic cavity, and that cavity is narrowed. So this, when you see this X-ray picture, when the pelvic cavity is narrowed, then it is a LC. Then comes the anteroposterior compression. APC injuries results from the direct force applied from the front, and symphysis pubis diastasis happens. Click. So if you see from front, the symphysis pubis is opened up, then you have a breakage of the ligaments, tuberous ligaments, spinous ligaments and anterior longitudinal ligaments. But in APC, the posterior longitudinal ligament remains, posterior sacroiliac ligament remains stable. So this has a APC 1 exact details, where the posterior SI joint ligaments are intact, intact anterior sacroiliac, sacrotuberous and sacrospinous. So this is quite stable. So APC 2 has, except all, everything is disrupted except posterior SI joint, and APC 3 is complete SI disruption with lateral displacement, which is very unstable and the patient can bleed to death. Lastly, it comes a vertical shear. When patient has a fall from height, you see that there is a displacement, vertical displacement is seen. Click. If you have a fall from height with extended leg, this is displaced. This is gone vertically, broken all ligaments, sacrotuberous, sacrospinous, anterior sacroiliac, posterior sacroiliac, fall from height from and the extended leg, the pelvis is gone up. So this is a vertical shear. So, and combined injury is a combination of LC with APC, LC with VS, and most common is LC with vertical shear. So coming to the management, we have a pelvic injury. We should treat as a polytrauma, because it can consist of visceral injury, it can consist of urethral injury, which can rupture the bladder, urethral damage, presacral plexus damage, patient can bleed in front of your eyes and can die. So it is a polytrauma and emergency. So management goal are, first is resuscitation. Don't go for the classification. First resuscitate the patient, then stabilize the patient, and then stabilize the fracture. And early up, and then mobilize and rehabilitation. So stabilization and resuscitation is important, and then everything becomes secondary. So once your patient is stabilized, you have anterior component to stabilize and posterior component to stabilize. There is a separate symphysis pubic damage, rami damage, which can be dealt with anterior approach. Posteriorly, we have sacral fracture, sacroiliac dislocation, and iliac wing fractures can be managed posteriorly. Emergency fixation is done with APC injuries, external fixation. When there is a vertical shear, patient is bleeding, you can apply a C-clamp. Definitive fixation, yes, anterior side internal fixation, this is not advised for definitive fixation. Internal fixation is advised, posteriorly also internal fixation is advised. So when you do a fixation for a pubic rami fracture, you have nowadays MATA plates available, which are anatomical plates, with which you can have a configuration of various angles of the screws, and you can actually have a very good stable construct of the pubic symphysis. Also, when you do only pubic symphysis, you should deal with posterior symphysis also. Posterior symphysis, either you can do a posterior anterior plating or a posterior percutaneous screw. So you can go retroperitoneal and put plates. Actually, you should put two plates, and you can do under image intensifier a percutaneous screw fixation. Posterior fixation for the sacral fractures, transilial rods, posterior plates. Posterior fixation also has a posterior screws. Anterior ala plating also can be done. So this is the direction of the percutaneous screw, which is passed from the posterior to anterior side in the S1 body. You have to take a good image intensifier. You should have a matching greater sciatic notch, 2 cm above is the entry point, and then under image intensifier with anterior angulation, you should pass this anterior screw. Vertical shear injuries are most notorious. External fixation can be done as an emergency procedure, but it is not good. It will loosen out. Video. So if you see here this animation, vertical shear injury, you have put the external fixator, we have reduced also quite nicely, you have put 2 shunt pins on both sides, connected everything, and the patient is resuscitated, but this gives instability. So this is not a definitive mode of treatment. Only anterior fixation It's not also good. It has a posterior elements. Videos. Two videos only.
Hello.
Yeah.
Please hurry up. Now yeah. Your time is
over. And this is anterior fixation is done, and the posterior still can have instability. So vertical shear has adequate stabilization consist of posterior component fixation, anterior component fixation. The anteriorly is fixed, it is moving, so you should put two plates posteriorly to have a good fixation. So in conclusion, I like to say that first is pelvic injury is life threatening. Second, so stabilize the patient, then classify it, and then go for a management. Thank you, delegates, Dr. Johri and Dr. Hitesh. Thank you.